everyone. Welcome to the Sawmill in Fort Saskatchewan and to 360 Alberta. I'm Jackie Fenske, and I have a very special guest this evening, and my special guest is Hedy Clausen. Hedy and her husband own Courier Equine Park, but we're going to talk a little bit about two movie stars you've got on the farm, Yahoo and Willie. This is a story of Equus, the story of the horse. How did you get involved, Hedy?
A lady named Linda Finstead from A Sharper Image in Edmonton, she's a photographer. She had actually been hired to scout out local horses that met certain requirements. So she had asked me if I would be willing to be involved in this project with my little 29-inch miniature horse, which I did. And then as time went on, my other horse, Willie, who is a half-Arab pinto, also was involved.
Great. Now, on Monday, you had to make this quite the trek to Edmonton, to the Wind Spirit. How did that all turn out?
It turned out just fine. Niobe Thompson, the producer, director, host, man behind this extraordinary film, contacted me about 10 days ago and asked me if we would be willing to bring our little miniature horse downtown to stand outside the Wind Spear and greet guests. Yeah, he, along with another horse owned by Eileen Poole, who is also in, I believe she is in Strathcona County, were outside greeting people as they came. It was a sold out performance on Monday. The Wind Spear was packed and the excitement level was high.
So you got to see snippets, or at least the second and third portion of the documentary. What did you think of it?
It was beyond anything that I expected. It was amazing, and I think that was the general comment. We knew it was a story of horse, but it was so much more. Niobe is an anthropologist, and so he was studying the connections of horse and man and how they've come through the ages, and so many amazing, interesting facts and things that he himself did on horses. He is very involved with the horses and, you know, has gone on some amazing treks and trips with the horses in various countries all over the world. Filming took pretty well 2 years to complete.
The trilogy, or this Equus, the story of the horse, has been sold to the United States. When do they expect that to be released?
It's expected to be released in the States in February, and I believe they're working on 5 or 6 other countries it's going to be released in. It's going to be a worldwide, absolutely epic documentary.
So, Hedy, just sort of on the human interest portion of owning a horse, because I know that people fall in love with horses. How would you suggest, if someone doesn't have connections, how would you say would be the best way to get started in loving and owning a horse, perhaps, at the end?
Probably the best way to get started and to make sure that it really is a passion, because you do have to be passionate to be with horses. It's a lot of work, a lot of money, but a lifelong passion for sure. And I think riding lessons are probably the best way to start. Find a reputable stable, take some lessons, and see if it's what you really want to do. And then when you're buying a horse, make sure you get an expert to help you buy that horse to make sure that it's the right one for you.
Right. So you give clinics, or you have clinics at the farm, mm-hmm. and people can register to audit a clinic. You don't even have to have
Absolutely.
A horse, right? How would they do that? Where would they find you, Hedy?
We're on Facebook, Courier Equine Park. Jim's coming in to do 10 3-day clinics in 2019. They're already sold out, which tells you a little bit of what the public thinks about him. They're sold out as far as participants, but unlimited auditors are welcome to come. And if you just look on the Facebook page, find the dates, bring your money and come. We'll be glad to see you on that day.
Please take a look at Equus, the story of the horse, coming to a CBC station near you. And I'm Jackie Fetsky, and I thank you for being with me here with 360 Alberta at the Sawmill in Fort Saskatchewan.